There have been a series of really, really exciting updates that we pushed to the traffic projection tool. I'm gonna cover them in rapid fire. The first being this dashboard here. We've made it a lot cleaner, so anytime you run a projection, you can clearly see the 12-month trend, overall traffic potential, and the ability to download all the data from it right here as well. So when you're setting up a new projection, we've added in a couple things. The biggest thing being the ability to add in gotta have it, must have keywords. So I'm gonna go ahead and set one up here. I'm setting it up for my personal website, Webris, our agency's website. We wanna run this for the United States. I'm gonna put in three competitors here that I just know off the top of my head. Map.com, LawRank.com. These are all competitors that are competing for the keywords that we want. Now you can enter up to 100 gotta have it keywords that if your website doesn't have it and the three websites don't have it, these to me are the focus of a lot of the projections that we do, because these are the ones that we say, okay, if we're gonna work with the client, we kind of know ahead of time the keywords that we wanna focus on, these are them. So whether your website doesn't pick it up to the competitors, this ensures that you do. So a very simple thing that I'll do is I'll just go into SEMrush and type in kind of some main keywords, download this to the CSV, and then you can just upload it directly to this. And then we just set it with headers, keyword, and you can see it pulls all the keywords through. So now we're done with the setup. This is building a database on the back end now, and it's just validating all these things. So it shows us the past 12 months of our website versus the three competitors. So you can just kind of see month over month how the traffic varies compared to the two. You can also just highlight on one if you want. So you just want to look at your website, you can see that we're tanking. You can focus in on the competitors to see how they're doing, or you can look at them all together in aggregate. And then down here shows you the total search volume, adding up all the keywords of each of the websites, and then total search value as well. Right, so value meaning volume times cost per click, and also throwing in the must-have keywords there as well. So once we have that, basically now what the back end does, it puts this into one big database, if you will. So imagine if you're gonna do this type of analysis in Google Sheets or a CSV file, it would take you hours to compile all this data from these websites and then get them into a workable format. So what the tool is doing now is it's pulling all that data into a singular database that now we can go in and apply forecasting logic to each keyword in here. So you'll see we have four scenarios here. Scenario one is saying, okay, this is your website's traffic. If over the next 12 months projected forward, you do nothing. You can see that we're losing traffic as the graph saw. You can expect 31 organic visits if you do nothing. Now scenario two, which is what this forecasting model is right here, is saying, okay, now if we were to focus on your own keyword growth, AKA keywords that are only on your website, not looking at competitors, not looking at gotta have it keywords, if we just improve the keyword rankings on your website, where will that take us? So this table here pulls through, you can see the keyword source, keyword smart website, keyword, website, page URL. We also add in a keyword intent, volume, cost per click, position, and then target position. So your job now is to go through these keywords and apply a target position for where you think you can get that keyword in the next 12 months, right? So it's 10, 5, and 1 in each of these, right? So if we like put position 1 here, you'll see what'll impact this number here by bumping it up by increasing the traffic. So if we got this one at 720 searches to position 1, then you can expect 144 visits at the end of the year from that keyword. Now, I like to use the apply target positions. Basically what this does is it excludes any keyword above position 20, any position from 10 to 20 to 10, 5 to 9 to 5, basically just moves this down automatically for us. So it will overwrite any work that you've done, just be aware of that. But this is a good starting pace. So you can see now that just based on applying that logic, we're now gonna estimate 172 visits per month at the end of next year. Now is when we start to go in and do some really detailed forecasting. This is really where this tool sets itself apart. So this advanced filter here, right? Let's say this page here, right? Our Miami SEO locations page. You can see good keyword volume, obviously really good keywords, SEO Miami, Services Miami, Miami SEO Agency. We're ranking between position 15, 30, 19. So pretty good, but the auto apply only moved us up position 10. I might say, you know what? I'm gonna hyper focus on these keywords for this client or for my website. I know I'll be able to punch them up. So what we can do is we can advanced filter by page path, contains, and then Miami SEO. And now this will filter out just this page or any page that has it in there as well. So I could then take all these keywords and say, okay, these 45 keywords, I really think if I'm being aggressive, I can get up to position 1, but maybe position 5. I think on average, we can get these up to position 5, right? And you can see that bump that up. Now we can say, okay, of the top search ones, SEO Miami for sure, SEO Service Miami, and we can just go through and kind of apply these on a one-to-one basis. You can see how this number keeps on punching up. You can also do an advanced filter based on keyword, based on position. So if there's a specific keyword in here, if we said something like, if we searched for keyword here, we said, okay, anything with law in it, we want to look hyper-focused at those because we're targeting law keywords, right? I just have to remove this advanced filter. So if we want to filter here by anything with law in it, we can look at these keywords. Anything with law in it, we can hyper-focus on these, right? So just giving you different ways that you can go through and slice and dice this data. You can also look at things like keyword intent. If you only want to look at bottom funnel transactional keywords, you can do that as well. Once you're comfortable here, then we move on to scenario three, which is now saying, now we're gonna look at new keywords, competitor keywords and seed keywords, AKA the ones that you uploaded. So you can see the keyword source here will tell you where this keyword is coming from, which website, or if it's a must-have keyword, the path, intent, same thing here. Now, again, I always like to start by auto-applying this logic. We're gonna let it do its magic, take a sip of our coffee. It just gives us a big head start here because you can spend quite a bit of time going through this and we can see this number is very big. So what I like to do when this number is too big, if we say, okay, this website is losing 84% of traffic year over year, you're probably not gonna jump them up to 25,000 visits at the end of next year. So what I like to do is I'll go through all the top search keywords here and just remove ones that I know are not important. So we can do this in bulk too. So all these ones here, you know, maybe we want to select the whole first page, right? Or maybe we just want to go through one by one, like Fine Law, Avvo, SEO for Lawyers, we might want to keep in there. Avvo Lawyers, we don't need. Law Firm, Gift for Marketing, anything that we know that we're not going to create content around, anything that we know is irrelevant to what we're doing. Lawyer books, we probably wouldn't create content around that. Law Office, SEO, etc. So if we then move these to exclude, we'll see this number go down. And what we want to do is we just want to keep on chipping away. We want to keep on chipping away to get this number to a point that's reasonable. And honestly, it's fine because we're giving them two scenarios. We're saying, okay, this is your own keyword growth based on what you currently have. This is best case scenario over here. So it's okay for this number to be big, but we do want to make sure that it's not anything unwieldy, especially if you're pitching this to a client that, you know, may or may not understand these numbers. After we get through that, now we've had made really big changes and improvements to this page here. So this is the traffic graph where we can see your website's historical traffic, right? So again, we see us losing traffic and we say, okay, if you do nothing, this is what you can expect over the next 12 months. If you focus on improving your keywords, right, this is what you can expect over the next 12 months. Remember that number we looked at, 697, you see it there at the terminal date at the end of 12 months. Then if we rank for new keywords, and then the total addressable market is adding all these up. So what's cool over here too is we added this little filter graph over here where you can see the monthly increase in traffic as you go based on each one of these scenarios, right? Historical traffic, you can see it losing. Then we have the four cards down here again, little hover cards here if you want to get more information on it. Tons of new information data here now too. We've added this table here for existing targets. So this one goes with scenario two here. So this says based on the total, you can either look at it landing page or keywords. So these are your best options for existing targets. We like to call these striking distance keywords, or, you know, best opportunity keywords. These are the best keywords: volume, intent, current ranking, projected traffic. Then we can do the same thing by landing page. Page path, total number of keywords that page is ranking for, total volume, top keyword, projected traffic, and then traffic value. And then we come down here to new keyword opportunities as well. Same thing. You do it based on keyword and we can see where the source is coming from. And then we can also do it based on landing page as well. Also, of course, the same thing for must-have keywords. Of course, they don't have a page associated with them because they're new pages, so it's only keyword here. And you can see total keyword, value, volume, etc. We also then organize this by traffic intent. So you can look at this at a funnel view, navigational, commercial, transactional, informational, etc. It aggregates all the total number of keywords, the total volume, projected traffic, share traffic, and then down here you can see this based on you know, a little bit more of a chart graph, if you will, and then the value of that traffic. The final thing that we've added, which I love, is the ability to export all this data. So we actually include this in all of our proposal rejection screens here. So you can see I just pop this open here. I'll just unzip this. And now if you're somebody who likes to work with your own data, we give you all the charts that you can look at and add into your proposals. but we also give you the spreadsheets. So you have the actual raw data here now, the done forecast. So if you wanted to do this in a spreadsheet format, it's here for you. You have the volume, the target, and the projected traffic. So we've handled all the heavy lifting for you, all the projected traffic for you, all the projections. You know, like I said, you can see that we add this into all of our proposals. This is a $20,000 a month proposal. And these three slides here were really what drove them. So you can see we're adding in the screenshots of forecast, the chart, and then also going through the top keyword opportunities and showing them volume, projected traffic. So this is what I wanted to share with you. Big updates here. If you have any questions, I'm always here for you guys. If you're a Blueprint member, keep in mind that you do get a discount, 25% off of this tool. If you have any questions on that, just leave me a comment and I will make sure that you get that code. If not, I'll see you in the next video.